Welcome back to Lions in London. Another look at Trafalgar Square as we get set for a very special Sunday game between the Detroit Lions and the Atlanta Falcons. Lions fans, let's hear it, because we have a very special fan, very special player with us now. Ndamukong Suh has joined us on the set. We certainly appreciate you taking time out of what's been an incredibly busy week. How has this been for you? You're a world traveler anywhere, so among all of your teammates, I would think that you might be the one providing some advice to some of these guys who've never been out of the country.
It's been a great trip. I've had a lot of fun with my teammates, been able to come into the city a little bit, especially the first day that we got here. We had a little bit of free time after our Play 60 event. It's been a blast. I mean, being out there in Bangshot was a lot of fun, or Bagshot, excuse me. And I've been to London before, so I don't need to see too many sights, because I got that out of the way. And actually, Trafalgar Square was the first square I've ever been to, as I stayed across the street when I first got here.
Well, you said Bagshot. Now, you told me it's a little bit rural. How's that compared to Nebraska? Because Corey Schlesinger told me there's nothing as rural as Nebraska.
It's pretty close to Nebraska being rural-wise. We enjoyed it. It's a great facility. Pennant Hill, the staff there took great care of us, and we appreciate everything, especially in allowing us to kind of use their England rugby field and tear it up a little bit. But hopefully we didn't do too bad.
You know, Coach Caldwell, I wouldn't say he threw you under the bus, but he certainly gave you a little bit of credit, saying that you were the one who suggested that the team might consider at least leaving Allen Park, perhaps for training camp. Give us your thought process behind that.
I thought it'd be great. I did jokingly give him a little trouble for it, to see if he would consider giving us have the opportunity next year to come out here and do training camp here in England. But
Saginaw Valley.
He went full bore. It's not just leaving Allen Park. It's leaving the country. No, why not? If it's on the company dime, you might as well take advantage.
Exactly.
Right?
And it's fun. I mean, I think it gives us an opportunity to enjoy each other and the guys just see different places and really just go out to dinner and have fun like we've been doing all week.
All right, I want to talk a little bit football here. Enough England. I'm not knocking England. It's a great place, but I'm more interested about football. Your defense this year has been dominant. There's no question about number one defense in the NFL. But if you look at it, it's pretty much the same personnel in the front seven. Tahir has been, filling in for Steven. What is the difference? Is it a scheme or players just playing better? What's going on?
I think it's a good combination of both. Guys understanding what they had to get done. It was a tough little transition going from OTAs and mini camps of learning the new defense, and then obviously coming in training camp and guys having a good opportunity of understanding what we had to get done. And then obviously really every single week is a new defense as we change for offenses and we figure out what we need to get done within our own scheme. But ultimately it comes down to the players. The players have been doing a great job of understanding what we needed to get done, how to execute, and how to communicate has really been the biggest thing, because communication is a key for us on defense, being able to talk through situations, because every single situation, even the one like last week when we had to play against a team that's been rushing 150 yards, 130 yards a game, and then they come out and all they want to do is pass against us, we had to adjust and adapt to that, and we did that as a team.
Let's go back a couple of weeks. Ever had more fun than you had against Minnesota? You guys were living in the backfield.
Minnesota was a lot of fun. I think the last time that I actually felt something of that nature was when we played Denver maybe about 3 years ago against Tim Tebow and his team. And it was a lot of fun. Minnesota is a great team to beat, especially being an NFC rival and a team that we respect. We're going to see them again, so we know we're going to get their best shot. And it was a lot of fun for us as a defensive line and really a front seven to just get after that O-line and that running back and quarterback.
Okay, I want to have you put your coach's hat on for a second. You've got your front seven. Let's look at the front four. Who do you think? Your play has been stellar for a lot of years. Who do you think has really stepped up their game that has really enabled this defense to take it to the next level?
I think from the front four perspective, I would probably say Ziggy Ansah has done a tremendous job, especially from last year where he was a guy that was really wide-eyed, just kind of like, all right, I got to figure out what I got to do, and asking a lot of questions and just kind of going out there and listening to people. But now he's taking it to another level where he's internalizing everything and then running from there and finding his own ways to make plays. And that's really exciting to see, especially somebody that I'm close to see a lot of success for him.
Veteran move by Ndamukong Suh right there, because he provided a perfect segue. I know that you guys have great camaraderie, and I know that your family is here as well, but I think Ziggy Ansah has the best story of the week. His sister lives here in London, and they had not seen each other in the flesh for 6 years, and I want you to hear what happened earlier this week. Here's what Ziggy did for his sister.
I didn't tell her I was coming, actually. I just, because I know her address, I just took a cab, went to her house, and just knocked on the door, and she just, like, fell on the floor, just, you know, overwhelmed.
Have you stayed in touch? I mean, have you guys emailed or anything like that?
Yeah, we do. Facebook, Skype. So we do talk, but we haven't seen each other for a while.
Do you anticipate that she's going to bring a little fan base to Wembley Stadium on Sunday?
Oh, yeah, she will.
That's a pretty sweet story. I mean, for a guy, could you imagine... Hey, sis. I mean, how sweet is that?
No, it's definitely something that we like to do as a defensive line. Surprise people, have fun with each other. And we do it a lot of times. We have a lot of games within our own defense. Even the coaches get involved sometimes. So that's very nice for him to do that to his sister. And it's tough that they've been away from each other for that long.
I know Gum's here. I know your dad's here. How important is it for you to have your family with you?
It's always important for me to have my family with me. Very close to my mom, my dad, and my sister. My sister's everywhere, making sure I'm in line. And getting to where I need to be at all times. So I love that my family is fortunate enough to travel with me, take a little time off of work because my parents are still busy at work, and it's exciting that they'll be out here to support me.
Now, you said you were here before and you spent some time in the city, and that you're not going to have to go around and do all the sightseeing. What was one of your favorite things when you were here before that you remember?
I think probably the most fun I had was just being able to see some of the sights, but I got to go to the financial district and take a tour down there.
Well, no, man, I have no money, so.
So that was a lot of fun. And then there's obviously Covenant Garden that's right around the corner one of the first places I got to go and look around and had some pizza over there.
Quick thought on the Atlanta Falcons, a team that surprises me with their record, a team that has a lot of weapons. How do you neutralize Matt Ryan, Roddy White, Julio Jones, and all those guys who are pretty good?
They've got a great core of guys and a great core group of guys that can definitely hurt us. Obviously, they're both the receivers, very dominant receivers. Roddy doing it for a long time. Julio been doing it since he got into the league. Matt Ryan's a quarterback you got to respect at all times. He understands what he needs to get done to get it to those guys. But I think another guy we got to be very cognizant of is Steven Jackson, a good friend of mine. Actually, probably going to have dinner with him tonight before I never talk to him again until after the game. He'll be another piece that we're going to have to worry about as well, and that we have to gang tackle.
Well, we appreciate your time, my friend. Good luck on Sunday. Let's give it up for Ndamukong Suh, who joins us here in Trafalgar Square. One more segment coming your way, but it is full of stuff. How about a Lions fan who won a free trip to England for this weekend's game? We're going to hear his story and much more as Lions in London continues from Trafalgar Square. Thank you so much for joining us tonight.